The periodic table of elements currently hosts 118 chemical elements, each with its own unique properties and principles. Elements are the building blocks of nearly everything we know and use in this world. From the air we breathe, the medications we take, and the electronics we use, elements are the fundamental building blocks of the universe. However, out of all 118, there are some elements that possess almost magical properties. Here are the 10 strangest elements. Number 10 is lutetium. Lutetium is a silvery white metal that was first discovered in 1907 by three scientists who had each discovered the element independently of each other. Lutetium cannot be found in its purest state, as it is always found bound up with some other elements. But lutetium is a very unusual element because of its extreme rarity, yet non-existent practical applications. In fact, lutetium is so rare that it is not only the rarest of all rare earth elements, but the entire global production of lutetium is just 10 tons each year. But beyond that, this strange substance has very few practical uses. In fact, just about the only thing that lutetium is even useful for is determining the age of meteorites. And because of how rare it is and how difficult it is to mine, lutetium is one of the most expensive rare earth metals, costing approximately $10,000 per kilogram. Number 9 is technetium. Technetium was given its name after the Greek word for artificial, because the only method of obtaining this element is through artificial means. But technetium is not entirely an artificial element. In fact, through spectrographic analysis, technetium has been detected in the cores of many stars. Beyond that, though, technetium can only be created through nuclear fission. Large quantities of technetium are typically produced using spent nuclear fuel rods. But on top of how difficult technetium is to forge, technetium is only present for just a few seconds during nuclear reactions. This is because technetium has no stable isotopes and quickly decays out of existence. In fact, most isotopes of technetium have half-lives of just under an hour. Beyond that, technetium for the most part is a strange yet short-lived nuclear byproduct. Number 8 is silicon. Without silicon, our lives would be much, much different, because silicon is the key ingredient behind computer chips and many other crucial electronics. Without it, our electronics and our lives as we know it would radically change for the worse. Fortunately, we don't need to worry about running out of this element anytime soon, because silicon is a naturally occurring element that comprises roughly 27% of the Earth's crust. Because of the immense importance of silicon, the section of San Francisco that is home to the biggest technology firms in the world is aptly named after this element. The place is called Silicon Valley. Number 7 is gallium. Gallium is a metal with a very unique property. Its melting point is 29.77 Celsius, which means that gallium will invariably transition into its liquid state right in your hand. Many people usually are shocked to see an otherwise dense metal turn to ooze with just a touch of a hand, and there is little to fear from gallium. Unlike mercury, gallium is a non-toxic element and is quite safe to be handled. Once it is removed from your hands, gallium will return to its metallic state. A popular prank among scientists in the 1920s was to mold gallium to the shape of silverware and then leave it for their co-workers to use while eating lunch. The pranksters would then watch as their colleagues screamed in horror as their utensils melted right out of their hands while they were eating. Number 6 is francium. The symbol for francium is FR, which mirrors the ISO code for the country of France. This is unsurprising, because this element is actually named after France. Francium is one of the alkali metals, and is best known for being the heaviest of the metals on the periodic table, and also the most unstable. Little is known about francium because it is so incredibly rare. It is theorized that on Earth, francium only pops into existence one atom at a time and is stable for at most 22 minutes. This is because when francium comes into contact with water, it will violently explode and leave the surrounding area flooded with radiation. This element is particularly dangerous because the moisture in the air alone is enough to trigger an explosive reaction. Scientists have estimated that only about 20 grams of francium can be found on the entire planet at any one time. As of this video's release, no practical uses for francium have been discovered, and no one has managed to collect enough francium to study this strange element in depth. Number 5 is curium. This element is a man-made element that was first discovered by Glenn Seaborg and was named in honor of the esteemed chemist Marie Curie. What makes this element so bizarre is that it is dangerously radioactive. In fact, curium is so radioactive that it will actually glow in the dark. Curium has been used as a power supply for NASA deep space probes because it is stable enough to generate power for decades on end thanks to its strong radioactive properties. Many have attempted to use curium in pacemakers because it could serve as a stable power source. This is particularly useful because a curium-powered pacemaker could theoretically operate without interruption for decades at a time, reducing the need for follow-up surgeries. However, unfortunately for that endeavor, curium glows bright enough to be seen straight through a human chest, and to this day, this element is rarely used due to its unusually strong radioactive emissions. Number 4 is antimony. This unusual element has had a long history with humans, dating all the way back to 3000 BC. Antimony was commonly used to make small items, and was even used in ancient Egypt as a form of eyeliner. Centuries later, antimony was used by monks to study alchemy. Unfortunately, all of these groups failed to understand the true nature of antimony. Antimony received its modern name from the French word for monk killer. This is because antimony is unusually toxic to humans, but as previously mentioned, its practical applications drove many civilizations throughout history to use this clearly dangerous element. Today, antimony is primarily used as a flame retardant, and unfortunately, the world supply of antimony is quickly depleting. Number 3 is bismuth. With the element symbol of Br, bismuth is the heaviest non-radioactive element and has one of the lowest levels of thermal conductivity. But what makes bismuth most peculiar is its unique appearance. Bismuth has naturally occurring staircase-shaped geometric patterns. Bismuth also has a very unique property. Bismuth is diamagnetic, meaning that it is negatively magnetically charged. Therefore, if you put a magnet between two pieces of bismuth, the magnet would levitate indefinitely. Bismuth has been used by humans since ancient times, although it was often confused for lead or tin. Today, bismuth is used for medication, cosmetics, paint, and bullets. In 2014, scientists began studying bismuth to see if it could safely serve as a cheaper alternative for lead wire pipes, and the results of that study have yet to have been released to the public. Number 2 is elements 112 through 118. These six elements, Copernicum, Enuntrium, Flerovium, Unnepentium, Livermorium, Ununceptium, and Unnanoctium are all man-made elements. Elements 112 through 118 cannot be found anywhere in nature and have only existed in laboratories and particle accelerators for fractions of a second. Elements 112 through 118 were all discovered in the last 20 years, with the earliest being Copernicum, which was recently discovered in 1996, and the newest, Ununtrium, which was discovered in 2010. Due to their artificial origin and very limited lifetime, it is currently being debated whether these elements will stay on the periodic table and if they have any practical applications at all. Number 1 is carbon. With the element symbol being a simple C, carbon is arguably the most important element on the entire periodic table. This is because, almost without exception, every organism on our planet is a carbon-based life form. Carbon is a key ingredient in DNA, proteins, cells, water, and even air. To put things into better perspective, carbon is responsible for 20% of the weight of all living things. Without carbon, all forms of life would not exist, and neither would a lot of non-organic compounds too. Oh, and also, the structure of the universe as we know it would be radically changed. For more top lists just like this, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that bell icon on mobile, or if you're on desktop, hit that gear icon and click send me all notifications. It really helps us out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next time.